Hi, Carrie here from My Quick Bookkeeping. If you're a consultant or tradesperson, you likely sell time. There's a very basic time tracker in QuickBooks Online that can be used to track your time, either for management purposes or to bill to clients, or both. I'll walk you through the steps to record time that will then bill to a client. Be sure to watch to the end of the video and I'll show you how to prepare and send an invoice with the recorded time included. We'll be using the landscaping company in QuickBooks to demonstrate this. Using the plus sign on the top right-hand corner, under Employees, select Single Time Activity. Be sure you have the correct employee selected, enter the date, and then the customer you'll be working with, along with the service you're going to be providing. This time is billable. Check the box and review the hourly rate. This is populated from the services we set up in another video. As with all of the defaults, these can be adjusted. Let's assume we have a contract with Cool Cars to provide a more highly specialized service at $100 per hour. And enter that rate here. We also have the option to select whether or not these are taxable. Note in Canada, this option doesn't appear at this stage. You can record the time in two ways. You can enter start and end times. This is something you may want to do as you're working during the day. Let's say we started working on this at 10 a.m. Then when we're finished, we make a note of the time. And if you've taken a break, make sure you record that here too. Let's say we took a half hour lunch break. Okay. And we're going to save this. At the end of the day, let's say our employee John comes in with his timesheet. He was also working on Cool Cars, and he was doing some gardening. It's billable, but not taxable. And there's no need to enter the start and end times. Let's just enter the 5 hours. Now, because there's no default rate charged for gardening, we can either alter the service item so it will show up next time, or enter it each time based on the different agreement, or perhaps even the employee carrying out the work. For John, at this job, let's say it was $25 per hour. We can also enter any further details in the description. Weekly gardening service, including pruning, how's that? Including pruning. And then we'll save it. Let's create an invoice for this customer to see how that works. As soon as you select your customer, any unbilled time will appear on the right. So we can see here, we have the design time and the gardening time. Let's add them both. Now, just as we edited this description when we added the time, we can also edit descriptions when we're in the invoice. So I'm going to type here as per agreement. Now we have to select a tax rate for our taxable item. So let's assume these services were carried out in Tucson. The invoice is now ready to send to your client, and an email will be populated based on the information you've set up in your customer. Well, here's an email. We can send and close. If you were using your company file, the invoice would now be sent to your client. You can set up to receive credit card payments in QuickBooks, which will help you facilitate more timely payments. There are also add-on services to QuickBooks that provide much more sophisticated time tracking. If you'd like to know more and determine which might be best for your business, please contact me. You can set up a free consultation through my website and we can discuss the options. We've certainly covered a lot. Please don't hesitate to reach out if you have any questions or would like help getting this set up. If this video was useful, please hit like below and subscribe to my channel for more QuickBooks tips and how-tos. Also, I've created a small business month-end checklist to help you be sure your records are up to date each month, so you can make the best decisions for your business. Click the link below to download a free copy. If there's another topic you'd like help with, please make a note below. My next video could be for you. Cheers.